Hi students, I'm Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on vocabulary and it is basically the challenge. That means when we upload a session on vocabulary, it is not of the same level. When the word challenge comes, you need to understand that the level of the words has increased. Basically, the words which are there in the challenge series, they are of higher level. That is why they become much more relevant than any other session. So if you like the session, press the like button so that I can upload such videos. I can bring more videos, more such videos for you. And if you share the videos, obviously your friends will get the benefit of these videos too. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, you'll get the benefit of all the exam relevant videos. And believe me, whatever we teach, whatever we bring, that's very planned. The questions are generally very, very selective. You'll get to see such questions in your exam. Good luck. Let's start with the first word. And the first word is congeries. Please understand the level and take it seriously like a challenge. Try to answer the questions. And if you'll be able to answer 2, 3, 4 or maybe 5 that you already know, please write down in the comment section so that even I can know. Let's say, you know, if I'm teaching students, what level you guys have. I'll be happy if you say that I already knew 5 words or maybe 6 words. I am starting the session. That's congeries. The first word is congeries and it means collection. See, the repetition has a purpose here. When I repeat, I feel that, you know, just by reading it, I'll not be able to teach you and you'll not be able to fix this word in your mind. That is why I repeat that by listening to it often, you'll be able to learn that. The example is given. By this example, I feel that you'll be able to translate the meaning in your mind forever. Congeries means collection. Congeries means collection. Congeries means collection. Our storeroom is littered with congeries of items such as jars, bottles, bags and boxes. Congeries of items, that means collection of items. Littered with, that means we are talking about something which is not useful at all. Which is not useful at all. So our storeroom is you know, littered with all the bad things, all the unuseful things are scattered here and there. And what sort of things are they? They are congeries of collection of items like jars, like bottles, like bags and boxes. That means our storeroom is very dirty. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Congeries, collection, and the next word is bottlerize. Bottlerize means censor. When we actually censor something, when we actually edit something, when we actually redact something, when I actually say something of this sort, I'm saying when we censor something, when we redact something, when we edit something, when we remove some part of it, it can be said that it is removal. Editing can also mean the same. Bottlerize can be editing. Bottlerize can mean editing, or you can say that removing some part. So that's why I've written the sentence here that certain sections of the film had to be bottlerized to make it suitable for a wider range of cinema goers. People go to cinema, that's why they're known as cinema goers. We are saying that when, you know, a few movies are there, if you remove only a few scenes, if you remove only bottlerize a few scenes, that will become suitable for more number of people. And who are those people? Who are actually the cinema goers. They go to the cinema, they watch the movies. We are saying you are preparing, you are making such a movie for the limited, you know, section, limited number of people. And if you remove, if you bottlerize some scenes, that means that movie will automatically become suitable for a wider range of people. So wider range of people, bottlerize. Bottlerize means to edit or censor. Till now we have learned congeries, that was collection. Bottlerize means censor. And when we actually talk about contumacious, I know that people are not familiar with such words, but you have to learn them as you are preparing for the competitive exam. This session is absolutely relevant for almost all the competitive exams, which, you know, exams which have English, basically. The section remains common. Contumacious means rebellious. Now you can see the example that will actually help you learn this word. The referee finally issued a red card to the contumacious footballer and sent him off the field. Is he on field? Is he on the field now? No, he was sent off the field because he was misbehaving. He was rebellious. He was not talking in the right manner. So contumacious footballer, contumacious player, contumacious cricketer, because they started, you know, they showed their rebellious nature. They are rebellious. That is why they were sent off the field. They are not on the field now. They were sent off the field by the referee because referee did not like that. The referee did not like that contumacious footballer, that means footballer, which was actually of the rebellious nature. The next word is etiolate. When something gets etiolated, that means it is getting weakened. If something gets etiolated, that means something gets weakened. The younger man could no longer endure the long and stressful days that had etiolated him to the point of a nervous breakdown. Please understand, this is the terribly bad thing. That's nervous breakdown. We all, you know what it is. I'm saying nervous breakdown happens. Somebody was on the verge, somebody was on the point of, you know, getting it, the point of, you know, nervous breakdown. He got etiolated to that level. That means he was weakened till that level. He was weakened to that level. So young man was stressed because of those stressful days. All those stressful days, you know, made him etiolated, and he was on the verge. He was actually to the point of, he was on the point of nervous breakdown. Etiolate, that means weaken, to weaken someone. Etiolate means to weaken someone. The next word is catatonic. That's unresponsive. When no response is given, when no response is given, when indifferent sort of attitude is there, unresponsive, indifferent, when a person is not responding, that's unresponsive, that's catatonic. Catatonic is unresponsive, when a person does not revert, does not give you the response. The share market seems to have slipped into a catatonic stupor because of misguided economic management by the central bank. The economic management by the central bank, understand that. The economic management by the central bank, you know, that management was misguided. That management, it was not the proper way it had to be. That is why, to get the share market, it slipped actually. And what sort of slip is that? It is basically slipped into a catatonic stupor. Catatonic, unresponsive, unresponsive stupor. And what's stupor? Stupor can mean, you know, it has, you know, meaning like, you can say listlessness, lethargy, sort of stable state has come where it is not moving at all. Catatonic stupor, where it is not responding at all. So catatonic means unresponsive, infrangible. When somebody tells you the meaning of frangible, that becomes automatically breakable. But when we say infrangible, as people generally make out by reading in, and they relate with this un, and they generally, you know, take out the right answer because only two choices are of, you know, that type. But as you can see, this guess is not going to work too much here, as we have in and four of the options. And only by just looking at such examples, students generally, you know, tell us the answers. Here the answer is unbreakable. Frangible is breakable and infrangible is unbreakable, which cannot be broken. So infrangible bond, marriage, we generally say that. Marriage is an infrangible bond, we all say that. Let's read the example. Many people still consider marriage a holy and infrangible bond that binds two souls for the rest of their lives. All right. Many people still consider, I told you the same thing, holy, pious, sacred, which is actually pure. Holy is pious. So holy or infrangible bond, that's marriage. We all know that, where two souls are getting united. Infrangible bond. Learn it like that, the way I'm telling you. Infrangible bond, unbreakable bond. And write down in the brackets that we are referring to marriage here. That's how you'll be able to learn. When you are actually going to take, you know, an exam, you need to understand that when I say infrangible bond and marriage, then you can recall that ma'am taught us that infrangible bond marriage, that means unbreakable bond marriage. The next word is maudlin. Maudlin means sentimental. Maudlin means sentimental, sappy. That's maudlin. That's maudlin. Maudlin is sentimental. Watching a maudlin film can be an exhausting experience if you are not mentally prepared for it beforehand. At times we don't wish to, you know, watch sentimental films. At times this happens that we are not in a mood. We wish to watch, you know, movies which are hilarious, which have, you know, stories which are actually funny or comic. But we are not willing to, you know, watch maudlin films. So maudlin films, where you get exhausted, where you feel exhausted, that exhausting experience, you are not mentally prepared, you know, beforehand, at the start, when you don't make up your mind and when you start watching such a film, it actually becomes exhausting or you don't feel like watching it. Maudlin film, sentimental film, at times, you know, we're not in a mood to watch such a film. So maudlin film, write down like that only, maudlin film, sentimental film. Demotic is popular, you can actually relate it with democracy or demagogue. So such words are going to tell you that this thing has a wider approach. When we say democracy, democracy is such a wider range, such a wider range. Do you understand that? It is such a wide thing. That is why demotic is also very wide. That means demotic is wide too, democracy, demo, democracy, demotic is wide too, wide, and that means it is popular. When you actually see such a thing, demotic is popular. See, though it does not have any relation with such a thing which I taught you, but I just wanted you to learn this word, that is why I tried relating it. Democracy is such a wide thing, demotic is equally wide, that means it is popular. It is almost impossible to translate demotic idioms of any language into another without any loss of literary flavor. When we say something in Hindi or in English or any other language, all the languages have, you know, and even the native speakers who speak, you know, such phrases, who use such phrases, they all know, they, when they speak, they actually feel that sort of literary flavor in it. We are saying when you convert one idiom into another, you know, language, you don't get that same sort of flavor because that loss of literary flavor is there. It does not remain that flavory. That is why it loses that flavor. So demotic idioms, that means popular idioms. Demotic idioms, popular idioms. Let's move to the next word. That's puckish. Not pukish, it has, you know, different meaning and the different spellings also. Puckish girl, naughty girl, puckish young girl, puckish child, that means we are saying naughty kids, naughty child. Naughty smile, here we are referring to the naughty smile of a kid. The young girl had a puckish smile on her face and soon it became apparent that she was trying to take us for a ride. She was actually enjoying and she was trying to make us, you know, fool. She was doing something of that sort. And she had that puckish smile on her face. Kids generally have such things on their faces. There's nothing new. Puckish smile, that means naughty smile. Puckish smile, naughty smile of the kid. Learn that like that only. Puckish smile. Write down puckish smile only. Don't write down only puckish. You'll forget the word I'm telling you. Write down puckish smile and then write it down naughty smile. Vicissitudes of life, we generally say that. That means changes which occur in our lives. Changes which occur in our life. Vicissitudes in our life. So a learned guide can help his disciple find a way to rise above the vicissitudes of life and attain self-actualization. Everybody who's actually, wish to do something in life, like a person who wants to be an ascetic or somebody like that, you wish to achieve self-actualization. And just to attain that, you have to go beyond, you have to leave, you have to, you know, move away from all the vicissitudes of life. That's what it is written here. And who's going to help you doing that? A learned guide, a learned teacher, a learned mentor can help his or her disciple That means student will be helped by the mentor, student will be helped by the teacher to do what? Find a way to rise above the changes of life, vicissitudes of life and attain self-actualization. Vicissitudes, the spellings are a little different. Don't forget, everything is single except the double S. V-I-C-I-S-S-I-T-U-D-E-S. Ablation. That's not ablution, because people are familiar with such a word. That's ablution. This is ablation. Ablation means removal. Ablation means removal. Cancerous cell, cancerous tissue was required to be removed. That is why such a sentence, right? Both the words. That is why you, that's it. That is how you are going to return this word. Ablation means removal. Ablation means removal. How you are going to keep this word in your mind? Write it down. Surgical ablation of the cancerous tissue. That means removal of the cancerous tissue. Can we keep, or do we wish to keep cancerous tissue in our body? No. We really wish to remove it. And how will we remove it? We are obviously going to do some sort of surgery for the removal. So that is why surgical ablation of the cancerous tissue was required to save the patient's life. You need not write the complete sentence. I generally don't prefer that, because you guys get to spend a lot of time in such things. Write down like that. Surgical ablation of the cancerous tissue was required to save the patient's life. Surgical ablation of the cancerous tissue was required to save the patient's life. Ablation means removal. The next word is swoery. The next word is swoery. Not swoery. That's swoery. Swoery means party. Swoery means party. The teenager was not allowed to attend the lavish swoery because of his casual attire. The teenager was not allowed to attend the lavish swoery, lavish party because of his casual attire. The teenager wanted to attend that swoery. The teenager wanted to attend that lavish, that grand party, but he was not allowed to do so because he was not wearing, you know, good clothes. Attire was the problem. He was just wearing casual clothes. Casual clothes, that is why he was not allowed to attend the party. Let's start the revision. The first word was congeries, which means collection. Collection of items, congeries of items, that you had to write down like that only. Bottlerize film, just write down like that. Bottlerize film, that means film had to be edited. Film, the scenes from the film had to be bottlerized. That means censored, edited, removed. Contumacious footballer, rebellious footballer. Etiolate, weaken. Etiolate him, that means weaken. Etiolated him, weaken him. Catatonic, unresponsive. Infrangible, that's unbreakable. Marriage, infrangible bond, told you that. Maudlin film, sentimental film. Demotic, popular. Puckish smile on the face of the child, that was naughty. Vicissitudes of life, changes of life. Ablation of cancerous cell, removal of the cancerous tissue. Swoery, party. Swoery, lavish, grand party. We are wrapping it up. Thank you so much.